dealing with baroque music is more than anything else dealing with dance, dealing with strong and weak. And in pop music, if you can't feel the beat, you can't dance to it, why bother? It's the same way with this music. If you can't feel the beat, if you can't get in the groove, then why listen to it? Why want to listen to it? And I think we can provide that. I think we provide the groove that you can get inside the music and rock with it, roll with it, slide with it, dance with it.
Baroque chamber music group. We perform music from the 17th and 18th centuries on period instruments like this oboe. And I think the reason we do it is that we're so passionate about the music. And we all have passions for the same types of music, so that works really well as an ensemble.
At intermission of just about every concert, someone comes up to me and asks me what this instrument is called. It's called the theorbo, and it's a kind of lute. It's a lute for days when they didn't have to fit into taxicabs. Lutes came in all different sizes, soprano, alto, tenor, and bass. So it's a lute with a very peculiar tuning. We can do scales. Across the strings instead of on the same string shifting around. This is an instrument, probably the soundboard and this sort of shallow back with all these ribs, each one of these individual pieces here, was a early 17th century style. And then in the mid to early 18th century, it was reconfigured. And this is a 3-year-old copy of that reconfiguration.
I'm sorry, no, it won't be. The track's there. And unless on 23, too much.
So the viola da gamba, as a Baroque instrument, plays bass lines and solo pieces, and it sometimes fits in a middle voice of a texture, like in a Brandenburg concerto or something. Yes, you can see the viola da gamba is the same size as a cello, pretty much, but it has 6 strings, and it has frets, fancy pegs. The sound holes are called flame holes. Another viol I play with Dryden frequently is a French 7-string instrument. It has an extra low string, goes down even lower than this one. And that was very popular for about 45 years in France at the end of the 17th century and beginning of the 18th century.
It's always interesting to try to put together a program that will make the audience go out and say, wow, I heard something that I'd never heard before, or I've never heard that played that way before. I never thought Handel could be so exciting. So we like to bring life to the music and work together to really come up with something special.
Looking back from the present, but looking at the Baroque from before, like coming into the Baroque period from the Renaissance, is that it's thrilling and dramatic and gripping and exciting.
This is a group that I consider the nice folks ensemble. We have fun.
It's good to know. In a good way. Yeah. Feel a heavy influence.
It's good music, too. It's good people, it's good music, and it's what I do. It is my passion, as Jane was saying. This is music that moves me like no other.
There are a lot of tastes in Baroque music that one acquires, a taste for the dramatic, a need for rhythmic swing and vitality, a love of contrasts, and it's something that you don't hear when modern instruments usually play Baroque music. It's certainly not what you hear in the elevator when you hear Vivaldi, but it's what was so important to the Baroque.
We've made so much music together. Hours of rehearsal, talking, arguing, loving what we come up with, that when we get together to play concerts, mainly what you're going to hear in the audience is a group of people who are creating music with joy, and what we most care about is just making this product right on stage. To hear it too, and you're going to hear our love for each other and for the music and for the experience of playing, actually for this wonderful audience in Princeton. There's nothing like it. The people here are so intelligent and interested. It lifts us up and makes us want to give a great concert.
I think the music is really exciting.
Fun and dramatic.
Just the drama of it and the lavishness of it.
And sexy and funky things, so. Makes me happy.